A new season is upon us, and that means it's time to update our wardrobes. Well, obviously this is a personal preference, but I've always had a fascination with runway shows and new trends each season. I love getting inspired. I love bringing in new pieces into my wardrobe to freshen up like my favorite vintage Levi's, or maybe pull out a blazer jacket that I haven't worn in a while. I love, love, love kind of just getting re-inspired with my outfits. So I thought it'd be fun to share five of my favorite fall trends from the runway. I also was thinking maybe I could do a video about how I bring runway outfits and do it my way, runway, the real way, my way. I don't know. I thought that'd be fun. So let me know if you might want to see that. But yes, I want to share with you some pieces and ways that I'm going to be updating my wardrobe this season. Super easy ways, pieces that I'm pulling out of my closet that I haven't worn in a while. And also be sharing some pieces that I think would be fun to add to my wardrobe. Maybe you'd be interested. I am a California girl, so I'm not talking about big jackets or puffers. Unfortunately, I don't need that. I wish I did. I wish I could wear faux fur and like a puffer jacket on the regular. That'd be way fun. These are just kind of some fun ways, which I think no matter where you live, you could totally incorporate into your wardrobe this season. So yeah, let's get to my five favorite trends, fall trends of the season. Alright, so the first fall trend that I'm really loving is neon. Pops of fluorescent color I'm here for. I've tried the black and white monochromatic look and I just like don't feel like it's me. I need pops of color and this neon is so fun and definitely not the usual fall color to me. I feel fall is very jewel tones, darker color, richer hues. But neon is so summer to me, so fun, so light. I think it brings a freshness for the season, especially if you're not in an area that's super sunny during the season. Definitely a neon pop of color. I just feel like it's a happy color. Who wouldn't want to wear happy colors? That's why I love color. I love pops. As you can see, I have some pops on right now. I really love what Tom Ford, Jeremy Scott, Balenciaga. I love how they incorporated these pops of neon. I mean, Tom Ford did these really beautiful leopard suits and Jeremy Scott did these really crazy raver type outfits, which is definitely not my style, but I do love the hues he chose. Oranges to beautiful lavender, these just beautiful pops of color. Balenciaga did that with these really cool neon turtlenecks. I want to find a neon turtleneck. I think that would be so fun with my vintage Levi's, so I'm on the hunt for that. But maybe these neon pops scare you a bit in terms of clothing. I think there's so many ways you incorporate them. You could incorporate them with your lip color. This is a really pretty hot pink. Not neon, but it definitely has the vibe of a beautiful neon pink. This one's Rihanna's from Fenty Beauty. I think your nails could be a great pop. I've done neon fluorescent yellow green before. For Coachella, I loved it. I did it in a gel. I feel like gel looks way more bright and just more saturated. But I do have this kind of muted green, which kind of gives a vibe of a neon green, neon yellow. Pretty easy ways you can incorporate pops of neon. Could be a belt, it could be a purse, it could be, like I said, a top. I did find this Zara crop sweatshirt, which I think is super cute, but like I said, I'm definitely on the hunt for a turtleneck. And I mean, again, makeup. Kylie Jenner, when she did her Get Ready With Me for Vogue, she had this really beautiful nude eye makeup look from one of her palettes, but she did a pop of neon, and I think that is really fun and understated. And Patrick Ta did this beautiful makeup look of Gigi Hadid with this neon pink eye. Obviously, I don't think neon pink eye would look well good on me. I think obviously depends on your skin tone, but neon pops of color definitely will be experimenting with. But yeah, tops, and I mean bicycle shorts would be a crazy cool way, comfortable way. I mean, that's obviously something I could wear in California, but yeah, definitely some neon pops, fun, fresh, happy. Who doesn't want a happy color? Wear a happy color. So yeah, I'm totally digging neon for fall. All right, next trend I'm loving is animal print. This is actually something I've actually already been wearing all summer long. I think it's the easiest way to add a kit to your favorite basics. I'm talking leopard print, zebra print, snake print, cheetah print. I'm talking the animal prints. And I love this because this isn't something that kind of makes me nervous to wear. I grew up with my mom loving leopard. So this isn't a print for me that makes me a little nervous or scared to try. My mom's always loved leopard, so she has an insane leopard collection already. So this is something like I definitely used to, that I definitely think adds a pop. It's pretty bold. So classic animal prints come in neutrals like black, gray, tan, white. But this season, I loved the bright animal prints that Tom Ford did, Diane von Furstenberg, Zadig and Voltaire, Givenchy, and I'm probably butchering this, but it's Miao. M-I-A-O. I'm not too sure what designer this is, but I just discovered them and I loved it. Their prints were in bright yellows, greens, and red, and like in a variety of ways, from animal print suits to tights to jackets to hats and dresses, which means there are so many ways you guys can incorporate this trend and experiment with and have fun with. I think a baggy zebra sweater is such a cute way. Wear that with your favorite black skinny jeans, and it's black and white, so it's not too scary from like a red snake print outfit. While I definitely am looking for a pair of snake print pants, I don't know, I think those are gonna be such a fun statement. Again, with a baggy, maybe black knit sweater, such a fun pop, super easy to try. Like I said, I've already been loving it. I had a really great leopard print dress from Boohoo, and I also have a pair of these leopard print track pants that are super comfy, would look great with a baggy sweatshirt. I wore it with the white bodysuit, but I feel like there's like endless ways to wear it, crop top for going out. So maybe if like those type of pieces are a little too much for you, I think accessories, you guys, a belt, snake print belt, I found one off Nasty Gal. I definitely think a bum bag, cheetah print, leopard print, a little crossbody bag would be so cute, super easy to style. But I'm definitely excited. I have these amazing snake print, like faux snake print booties that I got from Steve Madden last season, so I'm really excited to bring them out. Shoes are a great way to bring in the animal print too. Whatever your vibe is, I'm definitely feeling animal prints, and I'm definitely feeling them in these like bright, fun colors. So I'm definitely looking forward to bringing in some bright, bold animal prints this season. This next trend that I'm really digging is the Western trend. And this is a fun trend for me because I grew up around Western fashion, like Western pieces. My grandfather is from Texas and my grandmother's from New Mexico. So my mom always had a fascination with Western pieces, from turquoise to plaids to concho belts to cowboy boots to hats. She's always had this kind of Western element and this Western love that she's collected amazing pieces. She has these amazing black cowboy boots that I've been wearing that I can't keep and I can't wear. Those are her prized possession, so I can't really wear the crap out of them like I'd want to, but I've been borrowing them. She's been great about letting me borrow them. But yeah, these Western pieces, like I'm so excited for this Western vibe and to borrow some of my mom's pieces. But I really love how Isabel Marant, D Squared, Philosophy, De Lorenzo Serafini, Alberto Ferretti, Etro, and even Louis Vuitton created modern and chic cowboy pieces. From fringe and blanket jackets to denim shirting and cowboy boots accented with Western belts. I even love the way Zadig and Voltaire brought some chunky Western knits too. But I loved the addition of a little scarf and a Western belt that Veronica Beer did to accessorize a plaid dress. So just these Western pieces, I'm really looking forward to bringing. I mean, I feel like I'm right now wearing a flannel, which is Western, but it's also gonna tie in the next trend that I'm gonna be talking about. I definitely think an easy way to kind of bring in the Western vibe is with belts and boots. I'm really looking into buying a pair of black cowboy boots like my mom's, or some ankle booties. I'm obsessed with the metal cap toe Isabel Marant did. So freaking cute. I love it. I think, again, Western belts. I have this black one from Nasty Gal, which was like $8 to $10. I found some on Boohoo, but one of my favorite belt designers is called Below the Belt, and they do some great leather. They do faux leather too, if leather isn't your vibe, but the metal is just so much sturdier and stronger. I have a skinny one. My best friend has a beautiful double, like double belt one that's super cute that has actually been popular for a couple years. But if you have it, bring it out. I will link some belt options below. Like I said, Boohoo had some really affordable ones, and I'll link the Below the Belt ones that I really love that will definitely be worth the investment. But if you want to just try the trend and kind of like experiment with it, I definitely go with the affordable $8 to $10 option. But if you're really digging it, I would invest or even thrift or find vintage belts like that. There's so many that you can get. There's so many Western styles out there. But yeah, I definitely want some boots. If I don't, I don't know if I'll be able to get those Isabel Marant ones, but if I don't, Zara has some great cowboy options. I did see Aldo had some amazing options. So you can definitely get the vibe without spending too much, but but I actually do have, like I mentioned, the snake print boots from Steve Madden, and I have these amazing snake print like tan ones from Matisse. That those are my Coachella boots. They are the most comfortable boots out there, and I love them. I talked about them in my festival fashion video. Yeah, my festival fashion or my festival must-haves, one of them. But those are the most comfortable boots for me. I love them. I tend to wear them once, and other shoes get so uncomfortable that I end up wearing them all weekend. So they are so comfortable, definitely one of my favorites. So I'm excited to get more inspired to bring them out and rock them. And then kind of like fringy pieces as well. I have two fringe jackets that I don't wear often. One of them is this awesome baby blue Wrangler, which was a collaboration with Urban Outfitters. I wore it to Coachella, loved it. It's so beautiful that I'm like obviously keeping it, and I'm excited because I'm bringing it out. I actually wore it the other night to a Florence and the Machine concert, because as I was working on this post and gathering inspo, I was just, you know what, I'm gonna bring in the sweat. I'm gonna do the Western. I'm gonna do it, and I wore that with my Matisse boots, and I loved it. I got so many compliments on it, which was really fun because it was definitely not my comfort zone to wear Western type pieces, but I think that's what's fun about fashion, and you can experiment and try something new. So I was really pumped to wear that. And then I also have this black fringy jacket, which is amazing. The suede isn't the best quality. It was from Forever 21. It was a crazy awesome score. Pink is definitely more wearable. I know the baby blue is gonna be a little bit more bold, but the black will go with so many things. It'll go with great floral dresses, go with black denim. It has a vibe. It's a pop. So I'm really excited to bring out these fringe jackets this season. So Western pieces, you guys, boots, belt, I think are gonna be so easy to incorporate. They have, you know, collared kind of cowboy type shirts. I definitely think this will be easier to thrift and like find vintage pieces off Etsy. But like I said, Zara, Aldo, so many brands are doing cool boots. So yeah, Western pieces. Western style, I don't know. I think it'll be easy to do this with accessories, but I'm really digging the Western trend right now. So next trend I'm loving are colorful plaids. And plaid is such a fall winter staple to me. Definitely something that I've always loved. It reminds me of warmness and fall and coziness. But colorful plaid is what I call the ode to Cher Horwitz. And I hope you know who that is. And if you don't, she is the main character in one of my favorite movies, Clueless. I don't know why I'm so obsessed with that movie, but it's so nostalgic to me because it came out when I was 5. And I remember being at our local movie theater, seeing this poster of these like cute Barbie doll looking chicks and being like, I want to see that. Oh my gosh, I want to like be like that. One of the most iconic outfits she wore was this yellow plaid like skirt suit set. I mean, not a suit, but a yellow plaid jacket with the cutest plaid mini skirt. And it's just such an iconic yellow. And we all know it is from Clueless. And it's just an iconic look. Definitely not a look I would have worn in high school. I went to an all-girl school. Granted, I did wear a plaid skirt, but Versace did the plaid print in so many fun, colorful ways. Pants, blazers, jackets, sweaters, and dresses. Balenciaga had really cool bright color, not super bright, not neon bright, but colorful plaids in their pre-fall collection, from wide leg pants to baggy flannel prints, but in colors. I love the idea of like a super colorful plaid. I mean, this is my way of incorporating a colorful plaid. I'm definitely looking into doing a yellow plaid this season, but this flannel, which kind of touches on the whole Western trend as well, but a colorful plaid like this, I think is super fun, super easy way. I have it paired with a pair of high-waisted jeans right now, so it's super comfy, but it just adds a little pop. I'm really digging that. Even Dior and Gucci had some statement plaid blazers in a large check print that I love. But Michael Kors also brought in the yellow plaid with floral prints and some leopard and combat boots. So I'm definitely inspired to bring out my Doc Martin boots and pair it with leopard and plaid. Such a chic and fun look. Very badass and cool. I love the idea of leopard and plaid and, you know, some tough boots or maybe even some heels. Definitely want to experiment with that this season. But I will say, I definitely want to get like a boxy plaid, like a colorful plaid jacket. Isabel Marant, Miu Miu, as well as Dior had these really cool cropped boxy like jackets, kind of a men's style jacket, but in a bigger plaid. I don't know, I just love oversized jackets, always been my thing. Yeah, I do have this really cool shoulder padded statement blazer that I could bring out again. I'm definitely looking into finding a yellow plaid. I've never tried, never experimented with that, but I love what Versace did. I really like what Michael Kors did as well. Just such a fun, bold pop of color. And the last trend I'm loving is the 80s trend. And this one kind of makes me laugh and makes me roll my eyes because my mom would always tell me the 80s are gonna come back. And I was like, no, no, no. My mom grew up in the 80s. Well, she was in her 20s in the 80s, so my age. So she definitely knows what the 80s are about. She loved shoulder pads, big hair, glam makeup. She loved it. And guess what, mom? I think you manifested it because the 80s are back. Isabel Marant, Balenciaga, Marc Jacobs, Saint Laurent were some of my favorite designers that revived the 80s look. I definitely probably wouldn't wear the 80s like on the daily, maybe with a structured blazer that has shoulder pads. That is chic. I got inspired to bring out this baggy shoulder padded blazer that I got from Storitz. And as I mentioned, I do have a plaid blazer that actually has really elaborate, really cool shoulder pads. So I'll probably bring that out. But if I'm gonna do an 80s look, I definitely love it for a more glam night out look. Love the way Alexander Wang structured mini dresses with sheer black tights. I'm so obsessed, as I've already talked about, Versace's collection. And I think it's really cool because they brought three of my favorite trends in one look. They brought bright plaids, leopard, as well as this 80s look. The baggy statement blazers were pretty epic. Balenciaga did that as well. And Dior and Gucci. So that's really cool. This kind of 80s badass woman vibe. I'm totally digging. But yeah, I'm definitely inspired to bring out my blazers like I shared, but I think a cropped structured jacket will be super awesome. But I also noticed acid wash jeans. Miu Miu did some, Alberta Ferretti did some. So I'm not too sure how I feel about acid wash jeans because they're not 100% super cute in my opinion, but a great pair of skinny jeans in a cool way, maybe a cropped high-waisted pair might be super fun and super cute. I'm kind of intrigued to maybe try it in like a cool high-waisted cropped vintage pair. I did find some off Nasty Gal, ASOS had some, but I don't know. A little nervous about that one, but intrigued to try. But yeah, this 80s look, super fun, super glam. Versace just was it for me. I'm looking into, like I said, bringing in some plaids, but I love just the vibe of a little black dress with an awesome statement gold belt. I did thrift one at the Rose Bowl swap meet that reminds me, looks exactly like these Versace statement belts, big gold, cool buckle, black leather belt. I don't think it's real leather, but bomb, looks just like the Versace ones. And I shared that video, like vlog with me thrifting. Forgot what exactly, it was a vlog with me, but I talked about going to the Rose Bowl. So I might have to do a shop with me, Rose Bowl. That might be really fun. But yeah, so these are my five favorite fall trends of the season. Super fun, super easy ways to incorporate into your everyday wardrobe. I mean, for me, my everyday is Levi's. So plaids, blazers, statement belts. I mean, a little black dress with a black belt, very Versace. Animal prints, just super easy ways that this season is going to add a little bit more fun and freshness into my wardrobe. So yeah, I hope you like this video. And again, let me know if you maybe want to see runway looks my way, like runway the real way. Let me know in the comments below. But yeah, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Be sure to subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos from me. And I will catch you in my next video. Bye.